thought for the day is, the difference between failure and success is not much more than the changes we choose to embrace from one moment to another, one day to another. Greetings of the day to all. I hope, my dear students, that you all are in good health. This is Shreya Jadhav welcoming you all to my e-learning channel. And today we are going to learn English, grade 12, supplementary reading for The Enemy, written by Pearl Asbuck. So let us know something about the author. Pearl Asbuck, born on June 26, 1892, died March 6, 1973, also known by her Chinese name Sai Zhenzhu, was an American writer and novelist. As a daughter of missionaries, Buck spent most of her childhood in China. Her novel, The Good Earth, was the best-selling fiction book in the United States in 1931-32. She was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature for her rich and truly epic descriptions of peasants' life in China and for her biographical masterpieces. She was the first American woman to win the Nobel Prize for Literature. So now let us go through the introduction for answer. Prose name, The Enemy. Author's name, Pearl Asbuck. Genre, short story. Summary. Dr. Sadao was a famous Japanese surgeon and scientist. How he manages to fulfill his career and patriotism is highlighted in this chapter. So now let us start with the part 4 of the chapter. In the previous 3 parts, in part 1 we have done the whole summary and explanation of it. In part 2 and 3 we have started with the reading and explanation of the chapter. So now let us start with the part 4 of the video. This man will live in spite of all, he said to Hannah and sighed. The young man woke so weak, his blue eyes so terrified when he perceived where he was that Hannah felt compelled to apologize. She herself served him, for none of the servants would enter the room. When she came in the first time, she saw him summon his small strength to be prepared for some fearful thing. Don't be afraid, she begged him softly. How come you speak English? He gasped. I was a long time in America, she replied. She saw that he wanted to reply to that, but he could not. So she knelt and fed him gently from the Brooklyn spoon. He ate unwillingly, but still he ate. Now you will soon be strong, she said, not liking him and yet moved to comfort him. He did not answer. When Sadao came in the third day afternoon, the operation, he found the young man sitting up, his face bloodless with effort. Lie down, Sadao cried. Do you want to die? He forced the man down gently and strongly and examined the wound. You may kill yourself if you do this sort of things, he scolded. What are you going to do with me? The boy muttered. He looked just now barely 17. Are you going to hand me over? For a moment, Sadao did not answer. He finished his examination and then pulled the silk quilt over the man. So eventually, now what happened? That they all were, we have learned, we have seen in the previous part that Sadav and Hena both were really very worried about the step which they have taken, of why they have done this thing. Now, eventually, they all were in a perplexed situation. They were really very complex about the thing. But somehow when the man woke up and he was not aware that what actually was happening. At that time, Hena spoke something in English. So the Englishman, the American, felt good enough and he was a bit surprised that how can a typical Japanese woman can speak so good English. At that time duration, Hena said that she was also, she had also spent many years in America. And after that, when Dr. Sadav came for examining him to look at his wound, at that time he was lying down, means he was sitting on his bed. At that time, doctor, when he entered, he told that, do you want to kill yourself? Why are you sitting like this? Because the wound is still fresh enough. And if you do these things, you will be hurting your own self. And then it would be very difficult to cure him. At that time, the white man, the white American, asked him that will he be handing him to the cops or the army back. At that time, Sadav didn't reply anything. I don't know myself what I shall do with you, he said. I ought, of course, to give you to the police. You are a prisoner of war. No, do not tell me anything. He put up his hand as he saw the young man was about to speak. Don't even tell me your name unless I ask it. They looked at each other for a moment and then the young man closed his eyes and turned his face to the wall. Okay, he whispered, his mouth a bitter line. Outside the door, Hena was waiting for Sadav. He saw at once that she was in trouble. Sadav, Yumi tells me the servants feel they cannot stay if we hide this man here anymore, she said. She tells me that they are saying that you and I were so long in America that we have forgotten to think of our own country first. They think we like Americans. It is not true, Sadav said harshly. Americans are our enemies. But I have been trained not to let a man die if I can help it. The servants cannot understand that, she said anxiously. No, he agreed. Neither seemed able to say more. And somehow the household dragged on. The servants grew more watchful. Their courtesy was more careful as ever. But their eyes were cold upon the pair to whom they were hired. It is clear what our master ought to do. The old gardener said one morning, he had worked with flowers all his life and has been a specialist too in moss. For Sadav's father, he had made one of the finest moss gardens in Japan, sweeping the bright green carpet constantly so that not a leaf or a pine needle marred the velvet of its surface. My old master's son knows very well what he ought to do, he now said, pinching the bird from a bush, and he spoke. When the man was so near death, why did he not let him bleed? So eventually what happened? That the doctor and the Englishman were having a conversation. At that time, Dr. Sadav said that if he got a chance, then for sure he would hand him over back to the police, because he was a man of prisoner of war. He had come from there. He was hiding and he had come over here. And at that time duration, Hena was also standing outside and she was really very worried what to do. And then she said that now the servants are telling that they will not work anymore, or they are not willing to work anymore, because they think that as they are keeping the prisoner inside the home, they are betraying their own country. Now at that time duration, doctor said that it is actually not true. Why? Because the situation is something else now. Yes, we are all patriotic, but it would be very difficult for them to understand, because the doctors are always taught that they are supposed to, first see. They are not supposed to be racist, okay? They are not supposed to discriminate between the nations. And as a human being, his first effort is to watch that everything goes well. And at that time duration, the servants were dragged, means they were forced, not eventually forced, but they were not liking to do their household work. And moreover to that, the servants have also become more watchful. And at that time, one of the old gardener who was there when Sadao's father was young, and he made a very beautiful garden for him, and he said that his master's sons know, means Dr. Sadao knows what he is doing. And moreover to that, he was having a little bit of faith that whatever doctor is doing was good enough. But still, he was in a doubt that if the man was bleeding so much, what was the need actually to help him? Why would he save him? That young master is so proud of his skill to save life that he saves any life, the cook said contemptuously. She splits a full snake skillfully and held the fluttering bird and let its blood flow into the roots of the wistrous vine. Blood is the best of fertilizers, and the old gardener would not let her waste a drop of it. It is the children of whom we must ask, Yumi said sadly. What will be their fate if their father is condemned as a traitor? They did not try to hide what they said from the ears of Henna, and as she stood arranging the day's flowers in her veranda nearby. And she knew they spoke on purpose that she might hear. That they were right, she knew too, in most of her being. But there was another part of which she herself could not understand. It was not sentimental liking of the prisoner. She had to come to think of them as a prisoner. She had not liked him even yesterday when he had said in impulsive way, anyway, let me tell you that my name is Tom. She had only bowed her a little distinct bow. She was hurt in his eyes, but she did not wish to assuage it. Indeed, he was a great trouble in the house. So now eventually all the servants were having conversation with each other, and at that time duration, what happened? They all knew that they were speaking really very loudly, and they wanted it to be like that because they wanted Henna and Dr. Sadao to realize that what they were doing was eventually not correct, that it was not right. And somehow Henna was also accepting those things, but some parts she cannot understand. And at that time duration, she was with the prisoner of war, the American, and he himself, without even asking, he said that his name was Tom. And at that time Henna wanted to say that because of you so many troubles are going on, but she didn't say anything. As for Sadav, every day he examined the wound carefully. The last stitches have been pulled out. This morning the young man would, in a fortnight, be nearly as well as ever. Sadav went back to his office and carefully typed a letter to the chef of police, sorry, the chief of the police reporting the whole matter. On the 21st day of February, an escaped prisoner was washed up on the shore in front of my house. So far he typed, and then he opened a secret drawer of his desk and put the unfinished report into it. So eventually what happened that he thought every day he used to examine that what things and how the preparations are supposed to be done. The last stitches were also removed. So now he was nearly cured, we can say like that. But moreover to that, he started writing a report. And in the report, he wrote that there was a person on the 21st of February that was washed up to the shore in front of his house. He typed that much and then he opened his secret drawer. And then he kept his unfinished report in it. On the seventh day after that, two things happened. In the morning, the servants left together, their belongings tied in a large square cotton kerchief. When Hannah got up in the morning, nothing was done. The house was not cleaned, the food was not prepared, and she knew what it meant. She was dismayed and even terrified. But her pride as a mistress could not allow her to show it. Instead, she inclined her head gracefully when they appeared before her in the kitchen, and she paid them off and thanked them of all that they had done for her. They were crying, but she did not cry. The cook and the gardener had served Sadav since he was a little boy in his father's house. Yumi cried because of the children. She was so grieving that after she had gone, she ran back to Hannah. "If the baby misses me too much tonight, send for me. I am going to my own house and you know where it is." "Thank you," Hannah said smiling. But she told herself she would not call for Yumi, however the baby cried. She made the breakfast and Sadav helped with the children. Neither of them spoke of the servants beyond the fact that they were gone. But after Hannah had taken morning food to the prisoner, she came back to Sadav. "Why is it we cannot see clearly what we ought to do?" she asked him. "Even the servants see more clearly than we do. Why are we different from other Japanese?" Sadav did not answer, but a little later he went into the room where the prisoner was and said brusquely, "Today you may get up on your feet. I want you to stay up only 5 minutes at a time. Tomorrow you may try it twice as long. It would be well that you get back your strength as quickly as possible." So eventually what happened? The very next day, all the servants left their quarters. They were crying a lot, but Hannah didn't cry at all. The gardener and the cook were there in the house when Sada was a young child. They were serving the house from that long duration. And Yumi cried because of the children. At that time, Yumi told that the children needed her, then she could call for her. But Hannah decided that she will never call her for whether the children are crying or not. Moreover to that, Hannah paid the left dues also to them. And she prepared each and everything, breakfast up to making of the house, taking care of the children. Dr. Sadav and Hannah, both of them knew what the situation had happened early in the morning, but none of them said anything. After giving breakfast to the prisoner, when they came back, Hannah said that how long is it going to take? Other people can see the difference. Why can't we? Why are we different from other Japanese? And at that time duration, Sadao also didn't answer anything. He just stood up. He went inside the prisoner's room. And he told that he was supposed to, now make a habit of standing 5 minutes a day. And then he can double it the following days. He saw the flicker of terror on the young face that was still very pale. Okay, the boy murmured. Evidently, he was determined to say more. I feel I ought to thank you, doctor, for having saved my life. Don't thank me too early, Sadao said coldly. He saw the flicker of terror again in boy's eyes. Terror as unmistakable as an animal's. The scars on his neck were crimson for a moment. Those scars, what were they? Sadao did not ask. In the afternoon, the second thing happened. Henna, working hard on unaccustomed labor, saw a messenger come to door in the official uniform. Her hands went weak and she would not draw her breath. The servants must have told already. She ran to Sadao, gasping, unable to utter a word. But by then the messenger had simply followed her through the garden and there he stood. She pointed at him helplessly. Sadao looked up from his book. He was in his office, the other partition of the room, which was thrown open to the garden for the southern sunshine. What is it? He asked the messenger and then he rose, seeing the men's uniform. You are to come to the palace, the man said. The old general is in pain again. Oh, Henna breathed. Is that all? All? The messenger exclaimed. Is it not enough? Indeed it is, she replied. I am very sorry. When Sadao came to say goodbye, she was in the kitchen, but doing nothing. The children were asleep and she sat merely resting for a moment, more exhausted from her fright than from the work. So now Henna was working hard the very whole day in managing the whole house. Dr. Sadao was busy in his work. The children were sleeping. And at that time, there was an unknown guest knocking at the door. And he was the messenger from the palace. He was an army person. And he was asking for doctor to come to the palace. At that time, Henna thought that the servants might have complained. But eventually, they had come. The officer had come to take the doctor because Sadao was called for help because the general's health was not good enough. I thought they had come to arrest you, she said. He gazed down into her anxious eyes. I must get rid of this man for your sake, he said in distress. Somehow I must get rid of him. Sadao goes to see the general. Of course, the general said weakly. I understand fully, but that is because I once took a degree in Princeton, so few Japanese have. I care nothing for the man, Excellency, Sadao said. But having operated on him with such success. Yes, yes, the general said. It only makes me feel you are more indispensable to me. Evidently, you can save anyone. You are so skilled. You say you think I can stand one more such attack as I have had today? Not more than one, Sadao said. Then certainly I can allow nothing to happen to you, the general said with anxiety. His long pale Japanese face became expressionless, which meant that he was in deep thought. You cannot be arrested, the general said, closing his eyes. Suppose you were condemned to death and the next day I had to have my operation. There are other surgeons, Excellency, Sadao suggested. None I can trust, the general replied. The best ones have been trained by Germans and would consider the operation successful even if I died. I do not care for their point of view, he sighed. It seems a pity that you cannot better combine the German ruthlessness with Americans' sentimentality. Then you could have turned your prisoner over to executions, and yet I could be sure you would not have murdered me while I was unconscious. The general laughed. He had an unusual sense of humor. As a Japanese could not combine these two foreign elements, he asked. So now eventually, Sadao looked at the whole situation, that how Hena was so much tensed with the, not with the work eventually, but as the prisoner was over here. So Sadao went to the palace, and at that time duration, he told everything to the general, that what everything happened. And at that time he said that it is totally fine. I cannot lose you at this point of time, because if I will be you losing you, then it would be a great threat for him. So he told that it is better that you stay over here and not to utter anything like that again. Sadao smiled. I'm not quite sure, he said, but for your sake, I would be willing to try, Excellency. The general shook his head. I had rather not be the test case, he said. He felt suddenly weak and overwhelmed with the cares of his life as an official in times such as these, when repeated victory brought great responsibility all over the South Pacific. It is very unfortunate that this man should have been washed up on your doorstep, he said irritably. I feel it so myself, Sadao said gently. I could be best if he could be quietly killed, the general said. Not by you, but by someone who does not know him. I have my own private assassins. Suppose I send two of them to your house tonight for better. Any night, you need know nothing about it. It is now warm. What would be more natural than that you should leave our partition of the white man's room open to the garden while he sleeps? Certainly, it would be very natural, Sadao agreed. In fact, it is so left open every night. Good, the general said, yawning. They are very capable assassins. They will make no noise, and they know the trick of inward bleeding. If you like, I can even have them remove the body. Sadao considered that perhaps would be best, Excellency, he agreed, thinking of Hena. He left the general's presence then and went home, thinking of over the plan. In this way, the whole thing would be taken out of his hands. He would tell Hena nothing, since she would be timid at the idea of the assassins in the house, and yet certainly such persons were essential in an absolute state such as Japan was. How else could rulers deal with those who opposed them? So eventually both the General Takima and Dr. Sadao were having a conversation, and in the conversation both of them said, and they somehow decided that they would manage, and the General Takima would send some of his personal assassins over there to kill him, and Dr. Sadao was supposed to keep his window or the door of the balcony open so that they could enter and they would kill the person and they would take the body. Dr. Sadao was also continuously thinking about this fact only. He refused to allow anything but a reason to be the atmosphere of his mind as he went into the room where the Americans was in bed. But as he opened the door, to his surprise, he found the young man out of the bed and preparing to go into the garden. What is this? He exclaimed. Who gave you the permission to leave your room? I'm not used to waiting for permission, Tom said gaily. Gosh, I feel pretty good again, but will the muscles on this side always feel stiff? Is it so? Sadao inquired. surprised. He forgot all else. Now I thought I had provided against that, he murmured. He lifted the edge of the man's shirt and gazed at the healing scar. Massage may do it, he said, if exercise does not. So eventually, what happened that when Dr. Sadao came inside his home, he saw that the prisoner was not inside his room. And moreover to that, he saw that he was in garden. Doctor told that who gave the permission to stand up at that time. Tom, the prisoner, told that he was not supposed to take anybody's permission to do such stuff. And he was feeling good now. That was the reason that he wanted to, you know, have a small walk around the garden. And moreover to that, he told that he was having some swollen muscles. And when it would be possible that everything would be okay with him. So, we are keeping it till here today. In tomorrow's video lecture, we shall end up the chapter. Thank you everyone and have a nice day. I hope that every one of you have understood it.